see what else is on for sale around the country, and we'll check in with Tom Panos in the Sydney CBD studio. Welcome, Tom. How are you?
Hi, Chris. Hi, Arthur. How are you going?
Tom.
Very good. Now, we've got three properties this evening, so we'll jump straight into it. What's the first up?
Property number one is in Queensland, and it's from Sonia Treloar at Ray White's. It's a property that's on the market at $2.9 million, resort-style living, and it is about 10 to 15 k's out of the city. We picked this property when we spoke to Sonia. She said the fact that it was so close to town, a prestige property, and it has had the design done it by Shayna Blaze from The Block. So there's a bit of history there in terms of someone that's been able to have the ability to win a TV reality show to do this property. And we suggest that you go and have a look at it. I liked it also because it had a double page spread in the Courier Mail, which is our paper there in Brisbane.
So it's helped pay your wages this week?
Absolutely. It pays the wages, it pays the petrol, it pays the lifestyle, Chris.
But again, that building shot there is a fantastic photo. I mean, if you like a lot of land and you don't like your neighbours, then it looks like the perfect kind of property.
Absolutely. If you don't like people but you like real estate, this is the one for you.
Good stuff. OK, what's up for number two?
Number two is also in Queensland, but it's in Brisbane City, and it's come from a guy called JJ. I liked his name. He called me up and told me all the good things about the property. It's a six-bedroom unit at Casino Towers, And the other things that he's talked about this home, it's the first time it's been offered to the marketplace, a prestige location, top end of Queen Street, 35 floors above Brisbane River. It's got the facilities, pool, gym and spa, so you'd have no excuse, Chris, if you were living there that you're not at the gym every morning at 5 o'clock, and it's right opposite the casino, so it meets all your needs, and it's on the market at $3.5 million, and I think you can afford that as well.
Hey, look, I was on Sydney Harbour today and I got a call from the agent as well, and you've got to respect an agent that really tries and believes in his property and goes out there and makes as many calls as possible. So it's got to happen. We should have really said, well, maybe we should have spent the weekend there, Tom, and then we could really give it a good description.
Oh, Chris, I could just picture that I'd be up at 4:30 and you'd be coming home.
I'll be coming
at 4:30.
In. Exactly. Well, you do my gym for me, Tom. That's why you're so fit.
You're the best at outsourcing.
Exactly. Well, what's number three?
Number three is in Victoria, in Berwick, and Jared McRae's presenting it. He's the agent, and it was advertised in the Herald Sun for us. We're looking for buyers over $785,000 for this one here. Good rental return of $600 to $650 per week, and I suggest anyone that's looking for something in a nice, good street. It's got a great location. It's got a village atmosphere there, close to the, you know, restaurants and cafes. I'd go in and have a look at this property.
And certainly affordable housing. I mean, it seems silly we're talking about affordable housing at kind of $800,000, but that's the reality these days, isn't it?
Yeah, it's just changed so much, Chris. I mean, we are now talking, we're no longer talking about the 400s and 500s, we're talking about the 800s, 900,000s. So that is life in real estate, particularly in Sydney and Melbourne.
And look, I follow you on Facebook and Twitter, Tom, and I saw your 6 out of 6 last weekend. Any dramatic things that you're seeing out there?
Yeah, the first one in the morning, I just couldn't get over it, Chris. I sold the property at auction in December 2012, so only 8 months ago, for $930,000. Right opposite, across the road, same property in terms of location, in terms of size, sold for $1,150,000. We're talking about a $220,000 increase in 8 months. This real estate marketplace is absolutely hot. It's hotter in certain parts than others, but overall, I have not seen it this good in a very long time. $220,000 in 7-8 months is amazing capital growth.
Now, this goes to Arthur's point. I'm not sure if you're tuned, if you could hear earlier on in the show, but Arthur was saying that a lot of feedback from their last property chat, the Twitter chat, was that a lot of buyers out there are saying, look, we really want the agents to give us a price. But that just goes to show, I mean, that must be a good performer then, is how can the agents tell how much it's going to go for if suddenly a property's going to go up 200 grand?
Yeah, it's so hard, Chris, because look, in normal instances, when you don't have a growing market, I agree that it's no different to walking through David Jones. And if you're walking through a shop, you want to make sure that the items that you're looking at, the aftershave, the jeans, the computer you're looking at, it's got a price you don't want to walk around the retail outlet not knowing what the price of the items are. But in a marketplace where you've got individual properties that can sort of outperform because of demand and supply, it is very difficult to put the same price you would as you're putting in at a retail outlet. And that is a real issue with buyers, and I do feel for them, but at the same time, demand and supply means that properties are just going through the roof at the moment. But yes, the research clearly shows price guides get more views when people are looking at advertising. Yeah.
So they really need a star on the bottom of these ads with some fine print saying, look, we think it's going to go for $1 million+, but Tom Panos is auctioneering it, so it might go for 1.1 to 1.2.
Absolutely, and wherever you see Tom Panos, put that as your fifth or sixth auction to go to. Don't go that as your first, because you'll be paying good money.
Sounds good. Good to see you, Tom. See you next week.
See you later, guys. Bye-bye.
See you, Tom.
After the break, our thoughts on a home hunting hurdle.